Welcome today to room three of the historic King House here at the National Heisey Glass Museum. I'm Jack Burris, the managing director and curator here, and we have Nathan Hood filming today. I think architecturally, this room was the finest parlor in the house for the King family. Certainly these beautiful doors that were installed for a daughter's wedding are architecturally significant and would have been part of one of the best rooms in the house. And so as part of the history of this room, I think it was probably used for Christmas celebrations. And indeed, we have it decorated today, complete with a tree for the holiday season. Emmy Heisey, our president, has asked that we share our personal Heisey Glass stories. The story I'm going to share today involves a Christmas, as a matter of fact, multiple Christmases, connected to my family history. And the focus for today is some of the items that we have on the table. These items are all in the moon gleam color. As we know, Heisey made the moon gleam color from 1925 to 1935. And my family's history with this color dates to about that period. My great-grandfather was a banker in the Granville area and did some business with Mr. Heisey. So family lore has it that for a number of Christmases, a bushel basket of Heisey would appear on the doorstep on Christmas Eve. Mr. Heisey was a master of marketing. It was never a complete set of anything. The family always had to go out and finish off the set to have enough items to use it. The focus is the King Arthur pattern. This is pattern 3357. And the blown diamond optic bowls and the beautiful detail of the stems are just incredible. This is important to me because it's the first Heisey that I ever was aware of. And my mother used it for Christmas dinner. It came to my parents in the 1950s. They inherited a set of antique pink and white Haviland, and it was decided that they needed the moon gleam Heisey to go with it. So most of my childhood Christmas dinners included the green glasses that were Heisey, and they were called the green glasses by Heisey. This included the beautiful Gallagher jug, number 4164. I always remember having ice water in it. The fun little 500 octagon frozen desserts have an additional story to them, I think. In the 1920s, when these came out, it was quite a rare thing for a family to have home freezer space. So if you were serving a frozen dessert, it meant there was a freezer in the kitchen, which was quite a status item. And my grandmother remembered guests being very delighted and impressed when a frozen dessert came out in these beautiful little octagon dishes. So continuing with the story, my father was a mining engineer and we moved a great deal. By the mid-1970s, we were living in upstate New York. And my mom was a little bit sad that there wasn't enough of the King Arthur water goblets to do a really big Christmas dinner. So one day when I was in middle school, because of construction, our bus took a different route than normal. And while stopped at a stoplight, I looked over and in the window of a shop, thought I saw some King Arthur water goblets. I wasn't sure, but I thought they were. So on the following Saturday, I got on my bicycle and rode into town. And sure enough, in a shelf in the window, filthy dirty, were 6 King Arthur water fountains. Now, at the time, they were $10 a piece, which was way beyond my budget as a kid in middle school. So I talked my father into going back a couple weeks later. And I was amazed when he talked the man down to $8 a piece for those 6 water goblets. We took them home and secretly washed them and wrapped them and put them under the Christmas tree. And my mom's positive reaction to the goblets was kind of a hook that got me going. She was so excited to have enough water goblets to set the table. And indeed that year, we reset the table with the Moon Gleam King Arthur before dinner. The following summer, I was visiting my grandmother in Granville, Ohio, and we went to a house sale. And I found 5 of the sherbets in the pattern. They were my mom's Christmas present that year. And again, a very positive reaction. Years later, after the family had moved back to Granville, my younger brother came home one day in June and said, "Hey, there's a big show going on at the high school, and there's lots of that green glass over there." Well, I went right over, and that was my introduction to the wonderful antique show that took place for years at the Granville High School prior to our big formal show in Newark. There were many, many gifts at Christmas of Heisey from then on, and they were always appreciated and always enjoyed. And I'm very happy and proud to have a full service for 12 these days. And I enjoy them and think of all the family memories that have occurred around this beautiful glass. So for this year, I want you all to think about your Heisey. Get it out and use it for your holiday dinners. And start those traditions and plant the seed in future generations of collecting this beautiful glassware that we all prize. And as I love to say, Heisey has been a wonderful, cherished Christmas gift since 1896. We'll look forward to talking to you soon. Thanks so much.